Greetings from the Jersey Shore on a hot August afternoon. If we head down this way, we will be heading across the bridge to Toms River. This direction here is Seaside Park. But what we're going to do now is walk up Central Avenue and enter into Seaside Heights. Now, if you were to take this block here, Porter Avenue, just straight down, you would be at the Atlantic Ocean. So just to give you proximity of how close we are to the beach, if you just walked straight here, down Porter, there is the Atlantic Ocean. But it's only a couple of more steps until we reach Seaside Heights. So let's keep going down Central Avenue. And here we are. We are now entering Seaside Heights. Thank you for the visit, Seaside Park. Beautiful day at the beach. And now we are in Seaside Heights. As you can see, Seaside Heights and Seaside Park, same roads, same type of homes, different communities though. And we have a really nice a welcome sign now that we're officially in Seaside Heights. I'll walk you up a little bit further. And it really is a welcoming sight. It's the actual Seaside Heights welcome sign. And Seaside Heights is flying the United States of America flag. Very nice. Makes it feel like 4th of July, even though it's August. Now, same thing, if you were to go down DuPont Avenue in Seaside Heights, just like in Seaside Park, you would be at the Atlantic Ocean. Very, very close. And here is your official entrance. Seaside Heights welcomes you. It's great to be here, and thank you for the welcome. Till next time, from the Jersey Shore. Happy summer. Greetings from the MTV Shore House in Seaside Heights, New Jersey. Now, right around the block from the Shore House is the infamous Seaside Heights Wooden Boardwalk, and it's only one block over. So here is a hot August summer afternoon walk to the Seaside Heights, Jersey Shore Wooden Boardwalk. Right now we're walking down Ocean Terrace. And there it is, the Atlantic Ocean Boardwalk of Seaside Heights. And it's a traditional wooden boardwalk. Some boardwalks have been replaced after Superstorm Sandy with cement and with other construction types, but this has been repaired in a traditional wooden boardwalk. Here is your official greeting. Welcome to Seaside Heights Beach and Boardwalk. Now here is your lift ride that will bring you alongside of the beach. Now to enter the beach, you do need a beach badge. It is a Saturday, so you'd need a badge until 6 p.m. And here is a look of the beautiful Atlantic Ocean on a hot August summer afternoon. Now let's explore the boardwalk. Now this boardwalk will be open all night. The beach, on the other hand, that does close. But you can walk up and down the boardwalk for all hours. Now we're completely around the block. This is where we started. It was the Shore Store. That is where the cast of the MTV reality show, The Jersey Shore, worked. And now back to the boardwalk. Now where we entered there was a sign to try Polish ice, which is different than Italian ice, and very prevalent here alongside of the Jersey Shore. The concept is Polish ice is whipped, and it's much creamier, and I had it for my first time here at the Jersey Shore, and you'll see it at different shore points, Ocean Beach, Atlantic City, Seaside Heights.
Seaside.
Now, of course, you will find all of your favorite Jersey Shore t-shirts. Here's one to start, a hoodie. And all of these shops are right alongside of the beach. Now, there is an amusement park. Amusement park is up and running and doing quite well. Now, what's fun about this area is there's a carnival-esque element, so if you enjoy places like Coney Island, you will see some of the enjoyment of summer activities that may remind you of a state fair or a carnival right alongside of the beach. This one's fun, it's all lights. And here's some close-up from the boardwalk perspective. Sun is shining down. For those of you who like gaming, the arcade is open. Not yet a, not quite a carnival feel, different type of gaming. But I think the real attraction though is indeed the beach. Just beautiful. Nothing like having summer Jersey corn when you're at the beach. You can get it grilled right here. And the sweet smell, the sugar of the corn when it's being barbecued, it's really, really nice. I wish you could smell the barbecued corn. It's really amazing. EJ's Tap House, as the sign says. Welcome to Seaside Heights. There is a great place to enjoy a sunset, right on the roof, with that as your view. Now, it's been a few years since MTV filmed here for the Jersey Shore, but apparently it's still part of the attraction. If you look at the sky ride right here, see the Jersey Shore. As seen on MTV. There's quite a few nods to that era of Seaside Heights. Cheese balls actually are listed on the other end saying, as seen on MTV. Let's watch them go up. And come down. Yes, all of the fun of an amusement park, but yet you're still at the beach. For some reason, fluorescent colors go over really well at the beach, from gifts to t-shirts. I am wearing my Jersey shirt, and I got a lot of people ask me where I got this Jersey shirt from, and gotta say, love the shore. But my shirt is from Michigan. I could not find this Jersey shirt here, but there indeed are t-shirt shops all along the boardwalk, as well as fun hats. Here are some fluorescent beachwear. Now, as far as beach passes, you do need them, and you could buy them right here on the boardwalk. So you don't have to worry about going to a welcome center or anything far from where you want to be swimming. They're all right here. And this is in effect through Labor Day. It's a Saturday right now, so your wristband cost would be $8.
Pick up the all-day breakfast menu varies by location. Who needs to have such fun together? Romantic dinners, long weekends, concerts.
Now we're showing you this at about 5 o'clock in the evening in August, but there are other events that take place. There's actually free movies at the beach. There are concerts at the beach, so there's all different times to come here. And so we're only showing you this sort of sunset era. Oh, here's a sign for you. Free movies on the beach. And it's an inflatable screen that bounces in the sand. It's really just interesting to see how they're able to show a film on the beach as well as watching the movie. The sign that I walked past before said water temperature was about 70 degrees today. And there's really not a lot of waves, so it's easy to spend time in the water. For those of you who are bringing wheelchairs, it's actually very flat. It's an easy walk. If you're bringing a walker, it's an easy walk. Greetings from the Jersey Shore at Seaside Heights Beach and Boardwalk. Now, one's got to wonder, it's August of 2016, a few years after MTV brought a lot of popularity to this area of the Jersey Shore known as Seaside Heights. But is MTV a bad name around here? Does anyone in the community really want to associate with the show that they weren't on, or maybe even they were on? This is where it was all filmed. And surprisingly enough, the answer is yes. The original Steaks Unlimited is advertising on their marquee, home of the original cheese balls, which of course you saw on the Jersey Shore. But here it is on the marquee, home of the original cheese balls as seen on MTV. And this is located right here on the corner of DuPont and Ocean Avenue. And that's the story from the Jersey Shore. Till next time. Greetings from the Jersey Shore and welcome to Seaside Heights in the Garden State. We are right next to the Atlantic Ocean. And here is some beautiful carousel art welcoming us to welcome to Seaside Heights. And here is your hand-painted horse. Now, those of you who tuned into MTV to watch the Jersey Shore show may be wondering, how is the MTV name at the Jersey Shore in Seaside Heights after the show has stopped filming? Well, we're in the summer of 2016, and here is your answer. Tourist attraction. Visit the MTV house only 3 blocks away. Now, for those of you who do not have this information about MTV, it says 2002, the Jersey Shore with Snooki and Polly and the situation. That did not air in 2002, but there indeed was a Jersey Shore show on MTV with a completely different cast. And indeed, it's being celebrated right here in Seaside Heights. Till next time, from the Jersey Shore. Greetings from the Jersey Shore at the MTV Jersey Shore House. Now, for those of you who are wondering what is happening at the Jersey Shore House this summer, well, you can in fact take tours of the house and have your photograph taken with the duck phone. You can of course stand right out front here at 1209 Ocean Terrace. Cross street is Kearney Avenue, and I have your photo taken at the house if you want to do an outside shot. Or you can have your own Jersey Shore experience in the Jersey Shore MTV house, as it is for rent right now, and 1209 is the number. Now, if you wanted to go inside and do a tour, or to have your photograph taken with the duck phone, you would just go around on the boardwalk where the cast members worked at the Shore Store. They're open all year, 7 days a week on the boardwalk. And here's a map for those of you who cannot walk around the block, and they'll give you all of the information. And that is the story from the MTV Shore House in the beautiful Garden State of New Jersey. Till next time. Greetings from the Jersey Shore in the Garden State. Now, when you're trying to figure out what beach to go to, often it could be very, very, very inviting to go to more than one beach. So luckily, we have that opportunity right now. If we go to our left, we're in Ortley Beach, and if we go to our right, we are on the beautiful Seaside Heights. So we'll start here, and welcome to Seaside Heights, exit 82 at the Jersey Shore. Now, when you go to the right here, past the CVS, you'll be at the Atlantic Ocean Beach of Seaside Heights. And this is Route 35. And here is just a quick glimpse. Welcome to Seaside Heights. Now, the great thing about the Jersey Shore is there are so many communities right next to each other that you can visit more than one in a day. So let's go back and start this all over again, and I'll tell you a little bit more as we walk. The communities are really right next to each other. For example, when I went to Asbury Park, New Jersey, right next door would be Ocean Grove. One is a very festive town with rock concerts. The other is very tranquil and religious. So now we've got Seaside Heights, which we just visited. Now, when I'm talking about visiting, I mean stay for a little bit longer than I'm doing. This is just sort of the prototype, because these two signs are right next to each other. It's a great way to tell you the story of visiting more than one shore point. Here we are. Welcome to Ortley Beach. Really like this sign. You know you're at the beach when you see a seashell. Welcome to Ortley Beach. Now, the other great thing that you can do is, when I went into Atlantic City, I took the bus terminal, which is right there in Atlantic City, which brought me to Ocean City, New Jersey, and the very, very tranquil and beautiful Victorian Cape May. So it's so easy to get from community to community that I invite you, even if you have your favorite, check out another community. The Jersey Shore is beautiful from point to point, Sandy Hook to Cape May. Greetings from the Jersey Shore. Till next time. Now, when you're in Ortley Beach, I'll walk you down to show you how to get to the Atlantic Ocean. You see these folks are walking with their chairs. It's the same scenario. You would just walk down the block. And once you got down here, you'll find the pathway entrance to the Atlantic Ocean. Happy summer from the Jersey Shore. Till next time. Welcome to the Garden State of New Jersey, and welcome to the Lavalette Beach. Good afternoon. It's a hot August day alongside of the Jersey Shore, and here is a unique perspective of a walk alongside of the wooden boardwalk. Now, when you think about wooden boardwalks, you think about, I don't know, fries, seagulls, cotton candy, sweets, fluorescent t-shirts, and all the trappings of a good fun afternoon at the beach. But here alongside the Jersey Shore, this boardwalk is a very different perspective. The Atlantic Ocean is right over these dunes, and these are your Atlantic Ocean front homes. So it's really, it's a sense of serenity and quietness. You'll definitely have to have a second floor though, if you want to be able to see the Atlantic Ocean, which you can see all of these homes do have a second level, which is smart. And you're wondering, well, why would this be built up so high? And of course, for storm surge purposes, we are right, the next town over, if you can see further down the boardwalk, would be Seaside Heights. A lot of devastation during Superstorm Sandy happened. And so this is a, you know, good protective mechanism. You don't get the complete view if you're sitting on your front porch. But it's great because you have a completely different perspective than, say, the other communities, because it is really quiet. You don't have all of the shops, the restaurants. Water temperature is 70 degrees today, which does not match the air temperature. Streets are named after states. This is Philadelphia Avenue. Here is the Atlantic Ocean Beach entrance. And it's a late August afternoon. Water temperature is in the 70s. And the water is just so inviting. Waves are not too big. And there is a sign here, no animals are allowed on the beach at any time. So it's another thing that is unique about this. If you want to bring your dog to the beach, this is not the place. Listen. Now here is what I'm talking about. That is the type of second floor that you would need in order to enjoy the Atlantic Ocean views here at the Jersey Shore. Now look at this, isn't this colorful? Set up Adirondack chairs in rainbow colors. Now how about this, people? Your front lawn is the beach. It doesn't mean you can't have plants. There's some hydrangea plants. They're not flowering right now, but there it is, people. The beach is your front lawn. Well done, well done. So I hope, you know, this gives you an idea of the personality. You know, the Jersey Shore is so unique. It's so great when you visit a town because you can just walk over and see another town, and the personality is often quite different. We're now at Washington Avenue. For example, when I was in Asbury Park is a really lively town, and then you go to Ocean Grove, it's a very religious town. It's just a few steps, and it really makes for a great day to see two towns if you can in one day. And this is real quiet, well protected from the ocean. And then if we keep heading down the direction in which we are walking right now on this traditional wooden boardwalk, we'd be in the well-known town of Seaside Heights, well-known for fun, amusement park rides, concert stages, and a totally different Jersey Shore beach experience, which is really great. You walk from one to the other. I love doing that. And I invite you, when you come to the shore, to also do that, or come two different days. But there's really so much to see. And here is another beach entrance to the Atlantic Ocean. Now, you could see how much has been built up in order to protect the homes. And there is the beach back there. There are beach attendants. You do have to have a beach badge. And that's just a quick glimpse. Till next time, from the Jersey Shore. Greetings from the Jersey Shore. Let's check in with Teresa, who is visiting the Ocean City Boardwalk. Hey, Teresa, how's your afternoon?
Very nice. I'm lucky to be here. We are in
Ocean City.
Ocean City, and this is in the state of
New Jersey.
New Jersey. And they gave us a motto to live by. The sand may brush off, the salt may wash clean, the tans may fade away, but the memories will remain forever.
Very nicely said here. The sands will brush off, the salt may wash clean, and the tans may feed, but the memories will last forever. How is your memory making in Ocean City?
Today we are at the, I forget what beach we're
at. Ocean City, how is your memory making in Ocean City?
Well, I know I'm here. I'm enjoying it, and it's wonderful. The kids are enjoying it. Everyone's walking with a smile on their face. And it's good because we can't just be cluttered with labor and work and bills. Let's have fun. Life is young, and enjoy it.
Couldn't have said it better. Hey, everybody, it's Ryan and Teresa from the Jersey Shore. Till next time.
We're practicing our words.
Practicing having fun.
I wish you were all here. It's great. It really is.
Teresa, where are you watching the fireworks at?
Right in front of the Tropicana.
In Atlantic City.
In Atlantic City.
Saturday night at the Jersey Shore. No, they're on land. That's the fireworks in Atlantic City. So next time.
I thought they were gonna crack the ceiling open. Tomorrow.